This episode is actually also on video, so if it's confusing sometimes, then the picture is missing, and you can find it on YouTube and Facebook and stuff. I mean, if they didn't delete it because of copyright issues.
Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to Soulful Techno 100. I'm in Amsterdam at a brand new location. It's secretly opened because of Corona, and there's an amazing story about it, which I want you to share with. And first I have to say thanks so much to you, because I felt like I want to stop at 100. I got so much good feedback and donations and stuff, and I got really the feeling that you are really there listening and liking it, and that I do it really for something. I know I said this already, but it really means so much to me, so I can't repeat it enough. And to stick to the amazingness, I want to introduce you to Stefano Ketta, a really good friend of mine.
Hello. I'm so happy to be part of your show.
Yes.
Yeah, really nice.
And you have an amazing story to tell.
True.
You always had a dream, right?
Yes. I always had a dream to create my own location, because I'm from the events click, for example, but I'm always do it on a location from somebody else, and always I have the feeling I want to have my own location. I want to have my own location. I drive through this location for many, many years, and I was always thinking, oh, I want to have this location. And my girlfriend told me, mm-hmm. Well, yeah, but you don't have money and it's not for sale. So if it starts with the dreaming. It was just a restaurant, it was closed all the time, and then I thought, okay, what do I have to do to have it? And they told me, okay, I give you 2 weeks, and if you have the money in 2 weeks, it's yours. Then I thought, oh my God, 2 weeks, I don't have money, it's Corona.
what did you do?
What did I do? Yeah. Well, first I called the bank, can I borrow some money? Yeah, for what? For a restaurant. And what do you do now? Nothing. Okay. Okay, I thought, okay, that's not the way to... And then I thought, okay, let's call just friends to do a crowdfunding. Mm-hmm. And then some friends, they helped me. Oh, it was just 20% of it. And then I thought, fuck, I have only 7 days left.
In 1 week, you needed 80% of the money, okay?
Exactly.
Okay.
And then I thought...
How realistic is that?
Yeah, exactly. Then I was thinking... What do I have to do? Where's the money? At the beer browers. Mm-hmm. And then I invited all the beer browers to this location, but I was not the owner. I didn't have the key. I have nothing. So I make deals through the window. Yeah, there's the bar. And
Closed location. And this could be maybe mine. Yeah, can you give me money?
Yeah, exactly. So it was really, really strange. One of the beer browers, they Googled my track record, and then they thought, well, okay, let's give it a try. So I signed them for 4 years. If you sell tickets for events or whatever, then you get always like a kickback after your tickets, when you sell a lot of tickets. And I thought, okay, but if you contract me for 4 years and give me the kickback right now, cash in, then I have it already. I mean, it's the same now or after 4 years.
Okay, in 2 weeks you got the money. And then you told the owners, hey, I have the money.
Yeah.
And they were not like, okay, here's the contract.
No.
They were like probably starting thinking like, oh, if you can get the money in 2 weeks, probably you can maybe get more or really. Yeah, and then you called your uncle, right?
Yes.
And he has a wood company. And you brought in tons of wood and you started building the booth, right?
And then I make pictures, and I sent it to the owner, the old owner, and I said, I am building already. And he thought, this guy is really crazy. He didn't have the key, and we didn't get the bank yet, and whatever. But now, long story short, I'm the owner. I did it.
Man, that's nice.
It's
Oh my God.
Wow.
That is really so unbelievable.
I'm really happy.
So I think, you know, the amazing the amazingness about the story is, you know, if a realistic person, you know, would see this and you would have failed and they would just say, no, we just don't sell it, you know, then everybody would say, hey, Stefano, you're such a stupid dreamer.
Exactly.
How could you even imagine that you can have this place?
Exactly.
And now where you got it, everybody's like, oh my God,
oh
Stefano,
my God.
He's like this superhero.
Yeah.
And that's so amazing, you know, that this... It's a stamp of craziness,
exactly.
And success is so close to each other.
Yeah, true.
You know?
And you have to be a bit crazy to make this success and
exactly.
to do it. If he doesn't take that risk, I didn't have this beautiful location.
Yeah, that's me from the future. I didn't talk that much because it was kind of difficult to talk behind the booth. And the video is wacky. But you know what? It's just music. from the future again. I actually make like a collection of my favorite couple of tracks from the last 10 episodes, and then at the end some newer stuff as well. So I just wanted to celebrate a bit with my favorite tracks.
I know that shit fuckery. I was broke and I loved myself, nobody ain't love me. Don't judge me. Don't judge me. I know that shit fuckery. I was broke and I loved myself, nobody ain't love me.
Don't judge me, they kept me. Don't judge me, take care of my heart. Don't judge me, be of me. Don't judge me, just hold me in your arms. Don't judge me, take care of me.
Being black, being from the hood and 17 is powerless. The only change is when you get yourself a heater. I don't know why me and them opera started beefing. Do I blame me or the Willie Lynch theory? Born in the gutter, I know what my choice to be here. Funny how both my parents done the most to be here. We can walk free, but are we really walking free here? How can this be home when I feel I wanna flee here? I can't trust the police force and I can't trust the media. Learn more about my people from the streets than from my teachers. There's been a million speeches. No justice, no peace, cause we in pieces. Officer, am I allowed to breathe here? I didn't choose to be me, so why discriminate me? Paranoia, got the gang that rolling with it lately. Thinking how they gonna run up in my crib and take me. Rest in peace, Mark, you're forever in our prayers. No more betrayal, we need permanent changes. So we can move forward without turning back pages. We're feeling like strangers in this world that we live in. Lord, forgive them. No more betrayal, we need permanent changes. So we can move forward without turning back pages.
Let them all know that it's wrong, we are racist.
Help us feel proud when we look at our faces.
Don't judge me.
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 couple of minutes to go. Thanks for everything. I'm not going to talk too long. And it's just a pleasure. It's a journey. Someone is here who was with me on that journey for so many years. She knows all the shows, but she doesn't want to come here. Hello. Anyway, thanks so much for going through this with me, and yeah, enjoy the last couple of minutes. My name is Gabriel Ananda. Bye-bye.
And I forgot to tell you, the location is called Kaap, K-A-A-P, in the south of Amsterdam, and it's open from Wednesdays till Sunday. And I will still be here for you. Every third Friday of the month is like the date, and after that, Soulful Techno is released monthly. Oh,